Good morning from our last morning here at the Poly. Checking out today. Overall, I thought it was a very nice room.
I love the room. I think it's one of the best studios we've stayed in, for sure. I have two beefs with this room. Number one, the corner of the bed about took both of us out.
Yeah, it sticks out, I would say maybe like 3 inches past the end of the bed, so.
And it's like, it's not, sharp is a strong word, but I have a beautiful bruise on the side of my knee from cutting the corner too close.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, I feel like that's not child proof, child safe.
Yeah.
Which I mean, Disney isn't obligated to make everything child safe or Hannah safe, but you know, that was one beef, and the biggest beef is the ferry boat.
Yes. Basically, on that horn constantly from about 7:30 a.m. till like midnight, or sometimes past midnight, so not ideal for that. But the room itself is very spacious. It's one of the biggest, if not the biggest, studio on property. I do love the split bathrooms.
The bed was super comfortable and the pillows were wonderful. I loved our little balcony. We could see fireworks.
Yeah, we watched the fireworks last night for Disney Enchantment at Magic Kingdom. Yeah.
But it was still beautiful. It's been a really wonderful stay here at the Poly. You can't beat the amenities. All the food here that we've had has been great. I don't think we've had anything that was like, oh, or even, well, that's just okay.
Right. We've had breakfast a couple times from Captain Cook's. We got the to-go Kona. We had dinner from Captain Cook's when we got in here.
Mm-hmm.
Did our Tambu Lounge and Trader Sam Adventure. Mm-hmm. So.
And everything has been great.
Yeah.
I would still, of course, recommend the Poly.
Oh, for sure. Especially if you get Lakeview Studio, you are guaranteed this building, which is the closest building to the TTC.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have to walk all the way to the Poly to catch the monorail. You can just walk to the TTC and catch the monorail to either Magic or the Resorts or Epcot. So makes that very easy. Probably about the same walk to both monorail stations too.
But bring a white noise machine.
Yes.
Man.
For sure.
Or an app, something, because especially if you had little ones that were trying to sleep. I know we're here on our honeymoon and we're like, if you have children, but if you or a small child is a light sleeper, like me, you would not survive. Or at least you would, for a regular Disney day when you're getting up at like 6, if the horn is going until almost 2, things get a little complicated.
Yeah.
But again, that's all we've been able to pull from this.
Yeah. But overall, very nice day. Checking out of the Poly right now.
Yes.
And heading over to, probably not check in quite yet, but we are relocating to the Riviera Resort.
Yes.
So first time for both of us staying there. So excited for that.
Mm-hmm.
And today we're going to Epcot.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe some festival food. I think it's some pictures. And yeah. Which is a fun day in store.
Let's go.
Yeah. And of course, one last Dole Whip before we leave the Poly. One new addition to Epcot since the last time we were here is the opening of the Connections Eatery. So let's go check it out. Okay, so this is actually in the future, but our lunch at Connections, that's going to confuse me, Connections and Creations, Connections Eatery, very good overall. Very crowded. Hard to find a table. And it took a long time too. I don't know if that was because of the crowds or just it's new and exciting and everyone wants to try it.
It was 1 o'clock. Our time for pickup was 1:10. So, I mean, we were still in the regular lunchtime. We were towards the tail end.
Right.
But
we checked in right at 1:05. You could check in 5 minutes before your arrival time. And it took us basically till the end of our arrival time at like 1:40. So it took us a long time to get food.
To actually get the food.
So that was not ideal for doing a mobile order. But the food itself was very good. I tried the chicken sandwich. I would say quality-wise, reminded me very similar of like Chick-fil-A. Wasn't quite as like crispy as I would have liked. But the flavor was very nice. I think it's brined in like pickle juice. So there is like the saltiness aspect to the chicken itself, which was very nice. And the sauce that was on it was like typical, like kind of, I don't want to say remoulade, but the normal sauce that is used on like a Popeyes or a fast food restaurant's chicken sandwich. So overall, very good. My only complaint with it was very small. For the price especially, I think it was like $12 or just under. I'll put the prices below. But for that price, I feel like you can get a lot more and would be better used at the festival. Although, I would get it again. And what did you get?
I had a salad.
The General Tso's chicken salad.
Yes. Sauce on the side.
Yes.
For my picky eater friends out there. Hot tip, they let you do that. And it was a lot of food. It was very good. It was very filling. I liked the sauce, so I went ahead and put it, not sauce, the dressing. I went ahead and put the dressing over the entire salad, and it was a ton of food. Because you get 3 whole chicken strips.
Right.
Which is a little more difficult to eat than had it been cut up in the salad. I thought it was very good. The only thing I didn't like was the oranges. But I still ate them. I like oranges, but just not with my chicken tenders.
Were they mandarin oranges or regular oranges?
I think they were mandarin oranges.
Okay.
But even so, for being the picky eater princess of this party, I still ate it and ate almost the whole bowl, and I was stuffed.
Yeah.
You tried it.
Yeah, I think the salad is a great value. Basically the same price as the chicken sandwich, but yours was so much more food.
You got fries.
I got fries, that's true. I got a side. I chose fries. The other sides were like coleslaw or a Mediterranean salad or I think an orange. So I got the fries with mine, but yours I think is easily shareable. I think if we both shared yours, it would have been
plenty of food.
Might have still been a little bit hungry, but we were definitely satisfied after what we ate. And then for dessert, we went over to the, I think it's the Farmer's Market.
Farmer's Feast.
Farmer's Feast. I'll put that name below as well. But the booth that has the menu that changes 3 times throughout the festival for some dessert. So this is a different menu from where we tried originally. I'll link that video up above.
With the goat.
Yes, with the goat cheese, yeah. Cheesecake.
Cream sickle pop.
Yes, that place. So the dessert for this part of the festival is a strawberry rhubarb shortcake.
Upside down.
Upside down cake. Yes, you're right. And this was delicious. It was served very warm. The cream on top kind of just melted immediately when it hit the sun because it was very hot today. So, but yeah, flavor-wise was very, very good. The cake was nice and moist. The strawberry flavor was very strong. So if you're not a chocolate fan, this is going to be the dessert for you. But
I thought it was good. I was just not happy that it was over 90 degrees and I was handed a hot dessert.
Yeah.
The booth line was almost empty. Nobody was eating at the festival hardly today.
Yeah.
So I feel like the hype has died down a whole lot. So if you're willing to wait or come later in the festival, it's going to be a lot easier for you. But with that being said, it's going to get hotter and hotter in the summer, and then to eat a hot dessert, I don't think I would rush back for it.
But because it was so hot, we did not stay in Epcot so long. So then we left Epcot and came to Riviera to check out. So I will put in... Check into Riviera. So I will put in that clip right here. Okay, we have just checked into our studio at Riviera. And this is a studio with a preferred view. So we are in room 8484, overlooking the pool, which is very nice.
A splurge for the honeymoon.
Yes. Very fancy room on first views. So yes. On with our room tour. So walking in the front door with the front door to my back, just to the right here, we have a connecting door to the room next to us, which is most likely a one bedroom to make this a two bedroom lock off. And in here we have our closet space, actually a very large closet with a steam iron, extra pillow and blankets up there, the ironing board, a vacuum cleaner for all your vacuuming needs on vacation. This is also where the laundry hamper and luggage rack and the safe are for the room. And then turning to my left is the bathroom. So this one also has two bathrooms, similar to the Polynesian. A little bit different though with its layout. So in bathroom number one, we have the toilet as well as the very large walk-in shower that is all marble, or marble looking at least, with the detachable shower head here and the rainfall shower head there. And it's also a nice little bench in the shower and the traditional shower pumps and a nice shelf to the side. And turning around completely is bathroom number two, which is the shower tub combo as well as the sink. So very large sink, nice big mirror, and a nice makeup mirror as well. Plenty of storage underneath the sink as well, with the hairdryer down there. And one thing to note that is super cute is on the tissues, we have RR for Riviera Resort stamped on the tissue, which is very, very fancy to see. And then in the tub, very similar to the shower with the kind of granite walls, marble walls, with a traditional shower head and the normal pumps as well. And then turning around, we have our kitchenette, but I'll come back to that in just a second. First, we have a floor length mirror to check out your outfit for the day before you walk out the door. And to kind of give a little bit of a perspective, there is the front door again. And something I did not mention is right when you walk in, there is a small little table, which I currently have my sunglasses on there, as well as the trash and recycling for the room. And then on the other side, there's a nice little coat rack. So very helpful. And then turning back to the kitchenette area, we have our refrigerator and coffee maker, and then our microwave up above. Very large sink, which actually has a detachable head, which is nice. I don't think I've ever seen that in a studio room before. And our paper towels on the side there. And then plenty of plates and tea and coffee, and our ice bucket and cups. In this one, we have the toaster and bottle opener and can opener, as well as some more like coffee cups. There is nothing in the cabinet above the microwave. And then down below, we have some more toilet paper and tissues and paper towels, as well as the dish soap and sponge and whatnot, and the fire extinguisher. And then the last cabinet over here, we have another trash bin. And then turning towards the room, we were first greeted with a very lovely Mickey towel, which is very cute, very fun. And we have our nice big queen size bed here with a nightstand on both sides of the bed. Also has outlets in the walls on both sides, which is very nice to see that. And each of the outlets is two normal plugs and two USB outlets. And this side of the bed has two switches. So the one of the switches is for this light. The other one is for this light. The other side of the bed just has one switch for this light over here. But it looks very fancy, very plush. I do love the headboard. And I like the little Mickey up there as well in the molding. There's also plenty of storage space under the bed and some drawers to store all your clothes for your trip here. Just like a Polynesian though, it does stick out from the bed just a bit,
But it's rounded.
Yes, this Polynesian's was more to a corner, but this one is rounded, so hopefully that will help. But, and then we have over here our Murphy bed, and we'll pull that down in just a second, but we have some lovely artwork of the Riviera. Supposedly this is for Cars, maybe like Cars 2, because there is a car right there, and there's Lightning McQueen right there driving through in like the Grand Prix. So, very fun artwork. And turning around to the coffee table here, looks like we have another One Day at Disney book, as well as some drawers for some extra storage, which is very fun. And we have some two chairs and a table, and a nice oval mirror with a chandelier above. So, very fun. Odd to see that there's no lamp here, but at least there is some lighting with the chandelier up above. And then underneath the TV, we have our fifth sleeper position. So this would just pull down and reveals Pascal. So that's very fun.
So cute.
Yeah.
And there's a light inside this bed as well.
Yes, so there's a light switch to the side that turns off the light up top. But that's super cute. Very large TV as well. And then last but not least, we have our room view. Which we are overlooking the pool. So very nice view up here we have. Seems like it would be pretty quiet. We can watch the Skyliner at night.
You can see Tower of Terror.
We can see Tower of Terror, yeah, that's right. Kind of see it right there. So we might be able to see Hollywood Studios fireworks, potentially, if they have any of those tonight. Not sure. But I also love the railing that has a nice little hidden Mickey there as well. So super cute. And the chairs are themed to the resort with the RR logo as well. And pulling down the Murphy bed, we have a nice little painting of the 101 Dalmatians watching their favorite show. We also were just randomly gifted some happy anniversary balloons and a congratulations note from Tigger, delivered to us by the staff of the Riviera.
It's our honeymoon, but like, good effort.
Yeah.
And very sweet.
Very sweet, just to have some little extra magic be delivered to our room. So first thoughts on the room.
I think it's beautiful.
Yeah.
I love all the light colors and the open spaces. Mm-hmm. What I think is interesting about this honeymoon is that the Poly was probably closer to your style of how you would live. More warm tones, prints, and this is more my style with the light, open, airy, light colors, lots of space, lots of natural light and unnatural, bright, pretty chandeliers. So I'm excited to stay here tonight and see how we like it.
Indeed. So now I think we have to get changed and all dressed up for dinner. We're having dinner at Trattoria Al Forno, one of our favorites. So yeah, check in with you at dinner. Okay, and to end the night, we had a lovely dinner at Trattoria Al Forno, one of our favorites, one of our standbys. Consistently fantastic, consistently great service that we've had there. Cannot hype this place up enough.
I'm again so full.
Yes, same.
So full.
And we got pretty much what we've gotten before, our standby favorites. You got the Multibello to drink. I actually went off usual or unusual from what I usually do here. Usually I get the Tuscan Sour, The waiter recommended the Old Fashioned, gave that a try. It was very good, probably one of the better Old Fashions I've ever had. Very smooth, so I appreciated that. I did get the Tuscan Sour at the end as well. I think between the two, I do prefer the Old Fashioned though.
The Old Fashioned, you had me try it, and I didn't go like I normally do when you hand me bourbon, because yeah. I'm not a bourbon lady. But it was not, it didn't have the intense burn. So if you've wanted to try a bourbon drink and been like, oh no, you'd probably be okay with the Old Fashioned at Trattoria.
Yeah.
Trattoria, excuse me.
Had more of an orange flavor shining through.
Yes. Well, it was just, it didn't burn like crazy.
Yeah. So that was, our drinks were very good. Our server was great as well.
His name was Chris.
So every server we've had here has been phenomenal. Mm-hmm. Holly, Andrea, Chris. So
you're in safe hands.
You are
there.
Yes, 100%. And then for our entrees, we did not get an appetizer today. For our entrees,
it was too hot outside.
Yes.
And I knew I was going to eat all that chicken parmesan.
Yes.
Which is what I got.
Indeed.
I had to give him a little bit because I was so full. But again, as always, it was so good.
It is very good chicken parmesan.
I would eat that like every day if I could.
Yeah.
Once a week if I couldn't have it every day. Once a month if, you know. But every time we come to Disney, I'm always...
Trattoria?
How about Trattoria?
Yeah.
So, for that chicken parmesan.
Yeah. I had ordered the swordfish here. Now, I've tried a couple things on the menu here. I got the veal the one time, I got the swordfish, I got the shrimp pappardelle pasta. For me, that swordfish is phenomenal. If you like swordfish, get it. It is fantastic. I would never think to order swordfish at an Italian place like this, being like, I want to get a pasta. You are not missing out. This swordfish is incredible. The shrimp pappardelle pasta is also very good. So that would be my second recommendation. But the swordfish is just amazing, served over like zucchini and cannelloni beans with their classic red sauce underneath as well. Delicious. To the point where I actually asked our server if I could get the recipe for the swordfish. And he sent out the chef to talk to our table. And then the chef went in the back and printed out the recipe actually for the marinara sauce that they have there. And said that basically that's what makes the swordfish.
But enough for if we had our closest, like, 50 friends over.
Yeah, so I'll have to adjust the recipe because it calls for, like, 144 pounds of canned tomatoes and an extra 75 pounds of fresh tomatoes. So need to make some adjustments there because I'm not going to make that much sauce. But
he did offer to cut down the recipe for you.
He did. We were just already finished, had paid a check, so that's quite all right. But, yeah. Excited to try that out in the future. And then, of course, got a little celebration dessert for being on our honeymoon. So we got the chocolate gelato, thanks to Chris. Mm-hmm. So that was very good, very rich. Definitely tell that their gelato there is homemade. It does melt fast because it is homemade, but flavor-wise is
I think
excellent.
It's just a looser consistency anyway.
Yeah, it's a
because
softer...
Because it's not something that's... that has all the preservatives and everything in it.
Right.
They make it there.
Yeah. But that was it for our lovely dinner at Trattoria. So,
I'm so full, man.
Yes. So now we are back in our room, just kind of unwinding for the evening. Might try to see if we can catch some fireworks later today, but I don't know. We'll see.
We'll see what we can see.
Indeed. Not entirely sure. But that will do it for today. Tomorrow we have Hollywood Studios planned.
Well, we check out tomorrow.
Check out. We actually transfer to our next hotel.
Yes. Which isn't on Disney property.
Yes. I don't think we've actually said what we're doing after this.
No.
I'll keep that a surprise till tomorrow.
Okay.
So, checking out tomorrow.
We were only here for one night.
Yes.
Should we explain why?
Sure, go for it.
We were using my DVC points to stay for this honeymoon, and the Poly was our initial pick, and it was not available for all the dates we needed. So at first I was only able to get 3 nights, logged back on that morning and could add one more to the poly, but still couldn't get this last night that we needed. And then we had decided initially that we would do two nights at Riviera when we were stuck with three nights at poly only instead of the whole time. And then signed on, was able to get that fourth night at the poly. And then, okay, so we still need one night. Well, we'll do Riviera one night. I signed on that morning and the poly ended up being available, but we decided to just go for it, transfer resorts, do the split stay, and do one night here at Riviera.
Yeah.
And I'm glad we did.
I'm very
So far, I am loving it.
Yeah. Super nice to be on the Skyliner route. Very nice room. Very impressed by the room itself and the resort. It's beautiful.
It feels very upscale.
Yes.
They do their best to make it fancy.
Yeah.
But I am tired.
Yes. So that will do it for tonight. Tomorrow we have Hollywood Studios checking out, checking into our next hotel. But yeah. So that will do it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time.
See you real soon.